are beginning tonight with an Action News 8 investigation into the crime tip line, the gang crime tip line, as Salinas has suffered through a string of local shootings. Local law enforcement has pushed for the community to come forward with information on gang activity, at one point even begging for it. Cops set up an anonymous tip line. You've seen it on police cars, on signs, and in countless ads here on KSBW for months. But if you call the line, it might not work, at least the way the law enforcement had hoped. Action News reporter Mei Chow is in our Salinas newsroom with results of an Action News investigation.
Dan, we called this tip line countless times since yesterday, and we couldn't get through, so we went straight to the source, and now changes are being made.
Destination is not accepting messages because the mailbox is full.
This was a message after trying to get through to the county's gang task force crime tip line. It was set up for people in the community to anonymously report criminal activities. But what we discovered was that no one could get through, not even members of the Salinas Police Department.
You mean after you wait the whole 5 minutes to get to it?
You wait the whole 5 minutes?
That's a long introduction.
When we brought this to the attention of Deputy Chief Manny Perrin, he said he was not aware that messages were not being checked 7 days a week.
You know, it is unfortunate that we didn't have this protocol in place. It is changing right now, and I'm making sure that that gets done.
The mailbox was last checked on Tuesday.
This is the first time that our capacity has been tapped out. There's 19 calls that were on the tip line. 17 were all about the same exact incident, and I already had officers out there working on it.
If you see gang activity in Monterey County, call this tip line.
Local media has been pressed to do more to help police. KSBW did so by running the number for the gang tip line hundreds of times for free since last summer.
Monterey County Gang Task Force had asked for more citizen response, and part of KSBW's role in this is to report the news, but also can we be proactive and let people know that this tip line is available to encourage their stepping up and to be part of the solution. It certainly doesn't give me a great amount of confidence after the huge amount of public awareness that we've put out there that this had to be brought to their attention by us.
Now, about 15 minutes ago, the Salinas Police Department did issue a press release on their website saying that their gang task force tip line has encountered some problems running into a full mailbox, and they encourage people to still continue to call that number as well as offering a different line, 775-4222, and again, you can get that on their website. And Dan, another thing that came to light during our investigation is that the system can only handle 19 messages before it gets full. So when we brought that over to, when we brought that up to Deputy Chief Manny Perrin, he did say that they need to work on expanding the system so it can handle more messages before it goes full.
Or they could just get a cell company to donate one cell phone number that we could move this number to, and it would take all kinds of numbers.
Yeah.
And it wouldn't cost hardly anything, or they'd probably give it to them.
Exactly. They aren't taking any suggestions. And, you know, they also stress that people shouldn't call this tip line if it's not emergency or if it's not
right.
Ongoing. They should call 911.
Still, we should check the other number and make sure that that's taking messages.
Yes.
So, thanks very much, May. Appreciate it. So the phone number is 758-7400, and if you get through, you can remain anonymous.